my channel. Welcome back to another video. I'm Messy Jessie, and you're watching. Yo! Okay, so this is gonna be my thriller reading vlog. I'm so excited to be back to vlogging again.
It's been a minute.
If y'all want to see more vlogs on my channel, just let me know in the comment section down below. Anytime that there's a specific type of content you want me to make, just let me know and I will do my best to make it happen. But these are the books that we are going to be reading for this thriller video. First, I have Even If We Break. This is a YA thriller. I actually really enjoy YA thrillers about a group of kids who are getting together to play a game. We have Winter Counts, which is a thriller by a Native American author. And this book is set on a reservation and centers a man named Virgil Wounded Horse, who is dispatched by his people whenever the federal government refuses to prosecute an accused offender for a crime. So basically he's a vigilante and he decides to set out to discover who is trafficking drugs onto the reservation. We also have Never Have I Ever by Jocelyn Jackson. This is a book that has been on a few TBRs of mine throughout the year, and I'm just determined to get to it this year.
What the hell is this about?
Like, I should know by now because I've read the synopsis so many times on this freaking channel. Neighbors, her greatest joys, her family.
Boring.
Okay, so basically this is about a woman who has a charmed life who is being blackmailed by someone from her past who shows up. And then I also wanna get to Gods of Jade and Shadow by Silvia Moreno Garcia. This one I'm actually already reading. I am on page like, I think 113 or something like that. And this is about a girl who is poor and she kind of toils away in her family's house. She's seen as of lower status in the house because she is a poor cousin. And one day she's cleaning her grandfather's room and she opens a chest and accidentally releases one of the Mayan gods of death. This god takes her on a journey through the underworld. And when she opens the chest, she accidentally gets a piece of the god's bone in her finger, which means that until the god is fully restored to his power, they are connected and she will die if that doesn't happen. Testing out this lipstick that came my September feminist book club box. This lipstick is made by a brand. I think they're called Reina Rebelda, and they are a Latina woman owned brand out of Houston, Texas, I believe. Really like the shade, but I don't wear lipstick often, so let me know what y'all think of it. I kind of dig it.
Anyway, I'm digressing.
I have to take the pup on our morning walk, and then I'm gonna have brunch with my friends who I haven't seen. I have not seen my friends in months, so I'm really excited, and we're gonna get some reading done. Quick reading update on this book. I would not label this a thriller, but it definitely has creepy vibes because we're going into the underworld and we're associating with the god of death and his twin brother. And so far, I'm really loving how this book combines real Mexican history with Mexican folklore. It talks a lot about the political climate that this book was set in, which is set in the 1920s, and it is just so rich with mythology and folklore, and I'm just absolutely loving it. The incorporation of politics as well. The main character, Cassiopeia, is very vibrant. She's both pragmatic and temperamental, which is a really interesting combination. But so far, my favorite character is Hunkame, who is the god of death. He is so fucking amazing. I love when gods are main characters just because they are so otherworldly, but also have components that we can relate to. And I love him because he's so intelligent and powerful and haughty, but he's also very ignorant and innocent to the ways of the human world. And I just really, really like that trope. So I'm really enjoying this so far. It definitely has some disturbing and creepy elements, and the characters are all pretty vibrant. Even the characters that I don't love, like Martin, the characters that are supposed to be villainous and antagonists to the story, are all very enjoyable. So I'm really, really liking this. I started the audiobook. This audiobook slaps. This audiobook is so freaking good. I believe it's also read by the author, and he just has such an amazing narrative voice. So far, it's kind of setting up the establishment of the story, the establishment of life on the reservation, the kind of politics and the characters. So we're still kind of getting into the story. But I like that this story centers around a real world issue that federal prosecutors often refuse or decline to prosecute a lot of crimes that occur on reservations, which means that it is up to reservation residents to appoint people to kind of serve as vigilantes or serve to get justice. And so I'm really interested in kind of social law enforcement and other alternatives to law enforcement. This book is really good so far. Our main character is very disconnected from his heritage. He doesn't believe in the customs. So far, it's being hinted at why that is, but I'm interested in uncovering more about this character and who he is. I have not started these two books as of yet. Yeah, that is what I have so far. I'm gonna go for our walk. We're gonna go to brunch, and I'm gonna read more of the audiobook for Winter Counts on our walk, and I will check in with y'all after brunch. Was top tier. It was delicious, so good. However,
where was the seasoning?
We were at a well-to-do white-owned restaurant and the food was good, but where was the seasoning?
Salt, pepper, anything.
Anything. Anything. Can I just get a little hot sauce, please, when you have time? It's some salt. I am on page 110 of Winter Counts. Can I just say, I really do like the main character, Virgil, and the relationship that he has with his nephew is really touching as well. Like, his nephew is pretty much the only thing that he cares about, and I can relate to being a kind of character who only cares about one or two people because same. But Virgil's ex-girlfriend slash current love interest, Marie, is just getting on my nerves. So much. She's walking on my last nerve. Like, she's touching it. She's tapping it. She's poking it. I already don't like her. My pup was kenneled for the hour and a half that I went out to brunch. And so I think it's time for us to go for a hike. We hike through the woods quite often. We usually go and spend 1 to 2 hours out there. And it's a warmer day. It's like 30 degrees. Minnesota has decided that fall is just over. Like, I don't know who she is because she's not here. We're just officially in winter. It's been snowing like crazy. My dog has been loving the snow though, and it's really touching to see her play in the snow. We're gonna go for a winter hike, and I'm gonna continue listening to this audiobook. I will check in with you later. Hello, me again. Had to shower and change because I got so dirty at the dog park. We had a blast. We ran all up and down the beach. We ran through the woods. I ended up literally running into one of my closest friends and her friend and their dog. So we spent an extra hour just playing, and I was just covered completely in mud and exhausted by the end of it. Had brunch. Brunch was fantastic. It has been so long since I have gone out anywhere to eat, and I was really nervous, but it went really well. I also did some more reading. I've made really great progress in Winter Counts. I listened to the audiobook for most of the time that I was at the dog park, right up until I ended up running into my friend. I'm officially at the halfway point of this book. The mystery thriller aspect has kind of halted because the story has switched to focus on a domestic situation. Essentially, Virgil, I don't want to spoil it, but Virgil, our main character, has something bad happen at home and he has to take care of a family member. I won't say it's gotten boring, but it definitely has slowed down, and I can't knock that because I think it's still setting up for the rest of the story, and I can appreciate an author taking their time to like craft a story. And I do like that we are having a focus on Virgil's family life and building more about him as a character versus the mystery. So because of the pacing right now, I decided to switch to something a little bit more exciting and have continued reading Gods of Jade and Shadow. I have been flying through this book. I am only 100 pages away from its conclusion, and I am freaking obsessed. I love how completely action-packed it is. I love that it is told like a dark fairy tale. It definitely has some gruesome, disturbing components, but it reads very much like a fairy tale and is performed in the oral tradition, which I love the oral tradition so much. I also like that we are delving really deep into the psyche of Unkame. I actually really love gods as main characters, and Sylvia Moreno Garcia has worked so hard to create the psychology of a god. The way that they would speak, the things that they're concerned about, their patterns of behavior is just so well-crafted exploration of godhood and what that might look like. So I'm really enjoying the story. I can't wait to see where it goes. I also really love that this book features one of my favorite tropes, which is the journey trope. I'm really enjoying seeing these two characters, one immortal and one mortal, go on this journey through the underworld and from Mexico into different parts of the Americas in order to accomplish their task. I'm really freaking enjoying this book. So right now what I'm gonna do, because I did just do some reading, Akasha and I are gonna go to the local movie theater and pick up some popcorn. My local movie theater is selling popcorn for $3, and they have diminished hours, but you can just go and pick up some popcorn and take it home. And I'm really freaking excited about this. And I'm just gonna have a little movie night at home. My mom, who's a huge horror fan, told me about this movie called Spiral. It's about these two men who are married and they are raising a daughter, and they end up moving to this white rural community in the 1990s. And they are an interracial couple, black and white. So they are living with the dual marginalization of being an interracial couple, navigating blackness in white spaces, as well as being gay. And there's extra stigma attached to being gay during this period because of the HIV epidemic. And the storyline is basically, are these dads being paranoid and losing their mind, or is something supernatural, nefarious going on in the town? Is someone really out to get them? Really intrigued, super excited to watch that. So we're gonna go pick up some popcorn. We're gonna watch Spiral. It's on Shudder. I love Shudder. Then I'll probably do some more reading and I'll just check back in with y'all tonight. Was the bee's knees. It was so good. Whew, that movie was great. You have to watch it. It was, I wouldn't call it scary, but it was definitely creepy and disturbing and wasn't without its gruesome elements. Very, very good movie. I definitely enjoyed that. I haven't picked up more of Winter Counts, but I am now officially 30 pages from concluding Gods of Jade and Shadow, and I'm really into it. It's so good. I think right now, because I'm just really enjoying just having like a private little creepy horror night, I think Akasha and I are gonna go for a long walk. We usually walk for like an hour and a half, and then I'll probably continue listening to the audiobook for Winter Counts on that walk, that, or I'll listen to some BookTube.
We'll see how I feel.
We're gonna come back, watch this new movie that is called Z, and it's about this little boy and his imaginary friend, and it's one of those things where the parents think the imaginary friend is imaginary, and it's probably not. It's like a real supernatural creature. And I've said this so many times before on my channel, and I will say it again.
My kid not allowed to have no imaginary friends.
Okay, I've seen that movie and I die at the end. Funk that. Definitely gonna go for a walk, audiobook, watch Z. And I think tonight I might start Never Have I Ever, because I'm just really itching for this little domestic psychological drama thriller.
I'm ready.
To go to the dog park. I just wanted to let you know that it's, ow, ow, ow. It's the next day. We watched Z. It was messed up. Not as good as Spiral, but definitely enjoyed it. De hello. Thank you. Definitely enjoyed it. I'm gonna keep this brief. I started Never Have I Ever. The writing is better. The writing is better than I anticipated. And it's really good. I'm only on page 30. Please don't hurt me. I'm small. We went for a walk this morning and I read 30 pages of this, really enjoying it. Also had my morning apple cider, which is my favorite drink to have in the fall. It is essentially, I take normal apple cider, I heat it up, and I pour lots of cinnamon in it. And this is where it gets weird. Like, this is where some of y'all are gonna side-eye me, but I also add a lot of cayenne red pepper. I'm telling you, it is delicious. It is spicy and sweet and whatever cinnamon is, it's savory, whatever. It's so freaking good. It's amazing. So I did that, read this book, and I had a really good call with my mom. I did some planning for the TBR cards, which are about to go on sale. Obviously my dog is anxious. She's ready to go to the dog park. So I'm gonna take her to the dog park and we're gonna have some fun. I will check in with y'all later. Today is gonna be watching movies, exercising with the puppy. I want to take her to the dog park at least twice today and doing lots and lots and lots of reading. Okay, so it is a few hours later. We went to the dog park, had a lot of fun, and then I came home and took a nap and was asleep for 3 hours, y'all. Tips on how to wake up from naps with ease would be greatly appreciated because I'm always really tired between the hours of like 1 p.m. and 3 p.m. And whenever I try and take a nap, it just ends up with me taking the greatest slumber ever. Sorry, Akasha and I just got back from a long run and we also had a little puppy play date with our neighbor. So my nose is all red and runny. And I just wanted to show off a couple things that came in the mail. The first thing that I have here is from my Amazon wish list, and I have to give a huge thank you to Lena A for sending me my first ever Funko Pop. It is Maleficent. I have wanted this Funko Pop for like 2 years. I'm obsessed with Maleficent. I cannot wait to put this on my bookshelf. I am so freaking excited. Thank you so much, Lena. I was absolutely stunned, so thank you. And then every year on our bestie anniversary, my bestie and I send each other gifts. And so I already sent my bestie her gift. Not gonna tell y'all what it was because it's very private and personal, but she let me know that she ordered a bunch of books from Thrift Books and a few shipments are on their way to me, and the first shipment came. So I've already unwrapped the books from the paper, but I haven't looked at them to see what they are. They're sitting down below me and I'm just gonna pull them out one by one. I think there's 1, 2, 3, it feels like, and we're gonna see what they are. Okay, so the first one is, holy shit, okay. Yes! Okay, so this one is The 100,000 Kingdoms by N.K. Jemisin, which is a book I have been dying to read. Y'all know that I loved the Broken Earth trilogy. Oh my god, I cannot wait to read this. Holy shit. Yes! Oh my god, oh my god, oh my god. I love mass market paperbacks. I don't care what anybody says. I grew up with mass market paperbacks. I'm always going to love them. Always, 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 always. Okay, so the next book here is... Oh shoot. Okay, so this is An Ember in the Ashes by Saba Tahir. I think the last book in the series is coming out this year. I'm pretty sure this month or something like that. And I've been very intrigued about reading this. I don't really know what this book is about. I just know that it's a BookTube staple and I've been really wanting to read it. I know I look like I'm not excited, but I actually am. It's just that I don't know what to say about this book because I literally don't know anything about it, but I am excited. I've heard such great reviews. It's gonna be my first of her novels. I'm super stoked about this one. Ooh, and it's like a chunky monkey. I'm ready for another like thick fantasy to delve into. Okay, and the last book here. Oh my God, yes. Yes, 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 yes. Okay, so this is All Is Not Forgotten by Wendy Walker. This is a book that I've already read. It is a thriller, a psychological thriller. I loved it to pieces. Loved it to pieces. I read it through my local library a couple years ago. I'm excited to have a physical copy now. If my bestie is watching this, I love you. You made my day. You make my life better constantly. I don't know if I'm gonna eat dinner tonight because I'm just not very hungry, but I think we are gonna continue reading Never Have I Ever, and definitely gonna pick out a horror movie for tonight. I'm currently on page 70 of Never Have I Ever as of now, and all I can say is white people, y'all are too nice, okay? Because this lady shows up at our main character's house, is definitely on some power play, like takes the biggest seat at the table, kind of co-opts the conversation, starts asking people really personal questions, and like low-key threatens our protagonist, saying like, hey, I know your deepest, darkest secret. You should come over because we have some things to talk about.
Girl.
The protagonist the next day is like, oh, I need to find out what she knows. And she's like about to bake this woman muffins and take them to her house and be all that. No. Absolutely not. If somebody came into my home and threatened me, there is no way I would be baking her muffins and then going over to her house to see what she wants. That's not how that would go. It couldn't be me. Hi.
Last time I called, you said you'd send a squad car if there was another disturbance. Well, I'm disturbed.
Yes, Becky, tell him.
Another update. You'll have to excuse my appearance. Y'all are seeing so much of messy Jessie in this vlog,
and I'm so sorry about that.
I just got back from the dog park. We spent 2.5 hours there. Akasha had a freaking blast. It's about, what time is it? It's like 3:00 in the afternoon right now. And the reason this is the first time that you're seeing me today is because it has been quite a day. I woke up at 9, so way later than we usually wake up. We usually wake up at 7. We did our morning walk, and then I had errands to run. Now, my neighbor, unfortunately, she has lost her dog. Her dog and my dog do play dates all the time, and she's an older woman, and I just really, really love her. I love her. I love her dog. She's put up lost dog signs all over the neighborhood. The day that her dog was lost, Akasha and I were outside for an hour looking for her, and it's been about a week and the dog still hasn't been returned. My heart goes out to her because I've only had Akasha since August, but I already don't know what I would do without her. Like if anything happened to her, she was lost, I would just, I don't know. I don't even want to think about that. So I'm currently baking. I'm about to start baking blueberry muffins. I have this recipe that came in one of my feminist book club boxes early last year that I've been wanting to try. So I'm gonna make her some muffins and take them over. I've called her a few times and she hasn't answered, and I'm not surprised because I'm sure she's really depressed. And I'm just like, I don't want her to feel like I'm pitying her, but I do want her to know that I'm here for her and that I'm thinking about her and concerned about her. So hopefully it's not gonna be too intrusive if I bring over some muffins. This is the first time that I'll have baked in this house, so I'm really excited. I have salmon cooking in the oven. I'm gonna do salmon and Brussels sprouts for lunch, dinner. I haven't eaten a full meal today because I've just been on the go. I had my allergy injection in the morning. I did yoga and then dog park and walking, and that's taken up pretty much all day. So as of right now, I am 200 pages away from concluding Never Have I Ever. It's good, it's really frustrating. I could not be blackmailed. It couldn't be me, because if someone was like, oh, I'm gonna send you to prison if you don't give me $100,000.
Well, I guess I'm going to jail, bitch, damn, but I'm not giving you my money.
I'll tell you that much. What the funk do I look like? It's just frustrating because the main character is handling the situation in a way that I just personally wouldn't. Also, the reason I look like this is because I just got out of the shower, hence the towel. And I feel like I'm still covered in sand from the dog park. But I spent literally all last night watching movies. Ooh, my oven is ready. Okay, so the salmon's gonna go in. But I watched The Deeper You Dig. It was this really critically acclaimed film on Shudder, and they really didn't dig deep enough in that film. It was so bad. Honestly, that film was waiting the whole time for it to get better. And that's why I didn't DNF the film, because I was like, oh no, it's gonna get better. Like, it's super critically acclaimed. It's got such good ratings on Shudder. Y'all, horror fans, just don't watch this movie. Literally nothing happens. Literally nothing happens. The deeper you dig, nothing happens. That's what the movie should be called. That should be the full title. I also watched Fade to Black, which is an 80s horror film with Mickey Rourke in it. And did y'all know that Mickey Rourke used to be kind of cute? Shame. Oh, I watched this 1990s H.P. Lovecraft film. So it was based on one of H.P. Lovecraft's stories, and it was called From Beyond. And it was just like a very body horror, gross, yucky, typical like 80s, 90s sci-fi horror film. Quite enjoyed it for what it was. The whole time I was truly horrified. So it just was, it was very disturbing. And then I watched another film and I don't remember what it was. Okay, I'm gonna stop talking, put my salmon in, and keep reading. Another day, another reading update. I just have to show off my Jason t-shirt. Okay, comment down below with your favorite horror movie villain, especially if he's part of a series like Freddy, Jason, etc. I'm a Freddy stan. Always have been, always will be, but I do like Jason as well.
Okay, so
baked the muffins, they came out really great. They're so good. They're a little bit darker than I would have wanted, but the inside, I tried one and the inside was just perfect. Add some butter and some salt and it was excellent. So we're too short of a dozen because I had one and Akasha, she also had one. She seemed to have really enjoyed it as well. So at least it's puppy approved. Reading update, I currently am on page 274 out of 336. So I've got, what is that? Like 36, about 50 pages left, 55 pages. And I have to say, I'm actually starting to enjoy it now. It got really psychological and it's really delving into the psychology of these characters. And I like that the villain, her character, has become less flat. She's become a little bit more morally gray. You're a little bit more invested in her. So far, I just simply haven't cared about what's going on in the story. I'm bored, like the whole Stepford wife drama, the blackmail thing. I don't, like I said, it just couldn't be me. So I've just been not really interested, but now that everything is kind of coming together and the characters have been fleshed out a little bit better, I'm enjoying it and I'm really excited to see how this ends. I just, all I have to say is the main character decided really early on that she didn't want to kill this woman because, you know, she had a death in her past and she was like, I don't want to be responsible for somebody else's death. And I get that and I respect that. But there was a scene where she comes home and this woman is in her house holding her baby. And I'm sorry. Look. All I'm going to say is that woman would never be seen again. That would be the last thing she ever held. You're in my house holding my child. They would never find her body. That's all I'm gonna say. I'm almost done with the audiobook for Winter Counts. Akasha and I went on an hour and a half walk today when we woke up, and I continued listening to the audiobook, and it's so good. The story's picked back up. Really, really invested, really excited to see where it goes. Marie's character though, she is tap dancing on my last and my final nerve. I can't stand her. I love that she cares so much about her people and her customs and her culture. And she's pushing our main character to also develop that same type of concern and investment for his culture. I understand her pushiness, I do. And that's not the reason why I don't like her. The reason that I don't like her is because she keeps inserting herself into dangerous situations. and insisting that she can hang with Virgil as he's going and doing these dangerous things, and she keeps inserting herself, and I'm just like,
this girl would have died long ago.
It's just driving me nuts. I just can't stand her, but I'm really excited to see where the story goes. I have about, what is it, like 45 minutes left in the audiobook. I've been flying through it, so I am pretty sure I'm gonna finish both of these today. I still do have a little bit of Gods of Jade and Shadow to finish, and I'm gonna start this, so I'm hoping to start this today. Okay, so I'm going to go to yoga. I have yoga in about 20 minutes. I'm gonna drop off the muffins to my neighbor, and I really hope that she likes them and that she doesn't feel that I'm being intrusive by bringing them over. What else do I have to do today? I haven't eaten yet, so I'm gonna make some brunch when I get back, and we'll just continue reading. Also, I posted this on Twitter. Hey, I've been filming this like spooky reading vlog, and I've really been enjoying it. It's reinvigorated my love for vlogging and reminded me that it's like literally my favorite kind of content to make. And so I'm playing with the idea of doing daily vlogs every week for 2021. And I think it was like 78% of the people said, heck yes, this is something I would watch, like all of your vlogs I really wanna see. And I think it was like 18% or something like that said they would watch some. And then the smallest percentage of people said that they were indifferent. I would like to ask y'all who are actually watching this vlog, would you want to see weekly vlogs from me? And if you do, would you like watch them weekly, or would you just, you know, like watch them whenever you can? Depending on like the amount of people who are interested, I might even start doing it for the rest of this year just to like get in the mood, you know? Ooh. Okay. Okay, I'm gonna go to yoga and stop talking. Okay, so we are in the woods and Akasha's living her best life. I have my mask. I took it off so that I could film this update, but I dropped the muffins off and I like couldn't get into her porch because the door was locked and she didn't answer. So I called her afterwards and she said that she had, oh no, are you okay? Oh no. I'll be right back. Oh. Did you hurt yourself? Okay, sorry about that. I was walking beside someone because her dog and my dog were getting along really well. And I was talking to y'all and I looked over and she had fallen in this mud pit and was just having some life difficulties. So that's why I left, because I went to go help her out of the mud. So I brought the muffins over to my neighbors and she like had a dog bed sitting outside on the front steps and some dog food, and her gate was open, you know, in case I came back, and my heart absolutely goes out to her. So I brought her the muffins and she called, and I called her and she said that she had an update, like there may or may not have been a sighting and she had to go because another number was calling her, and she said that it might be in relation to the dog. So fingers crossed that someone was calling her saying they had found her dog and it's getting returned to her right now. We just went to the dog park, we had a blast, and I found this package on my doorstep from HarperCollins. It's one book and it's very thick. Oh my gosh! Hey! Okay, I am so excited about this. Yes! All right, so HarperCollins sent me Plain Bad Heroines by Emily M. Danforth. Ooh, and this has illustrations in it by Sarah Lottman. I am very excited about this. I don't know too much about this, but I know that it is dark academia, which is all the rage right now. New England boarding school for girls, sapphic love, rebellious female spirit, and it's an adult horror comedy. So that's pretty much all I need to know about this book. And I know that this book has been making the rounds. There's some hype surrounding it. So I am excited to get to it myself. I haven't been able to get any reading done today, so I'm going to hunker down and try and finish some books. Okay, so I think I figured out what about this type of novel is bugging me. And it's this trope of, I have a deep, dark secret from my old past that my new friends and my new partner and my new children don't know about. And I have to protect them from the secret so that they will continue loving me. That whole trope just doesn't speak to me. And I've realized the reason why it doesn't speak to me. It's because if I can't be my true self with the people that I love, then they don't love me and I don't love them. I'm not interested in any kind of platonic, romantic type of love where I have to hide a large portion of who I am. Maybe it's because I had to be in the closet for so long, but that whole trope of like, yeah, I'm gonna let somebody blackmail me so that my new family doesn't find out about my dark past, it just doesn't speak to me, because I'm like, if I have to shield you from my history and our relationship is so fragile that it can't survive my past, then I don't know. It's just, am I the only one who feels this way?
I did not see that coming. And never have I ever been so traumatized. Please help. I have 15 pages left of this book.
Pray for me.
Ew.
Gross.
Oh my God, this is so gross.
Yes.
Kill her. Shit.
Okay, so I finished Never Have I Ever. I have a lot of thoughts, but this video is getting so long, so I'm gonna save them for my wrap up. All I'm gonna say is I did not see the ending coming, and so far the book was gonna be a 3-star, but with the ending, just because of my sheer shock, I'm gonna bump it up to a 4. I'm gonna finish Gods of Jade and Shadow now.
To say hi? Did you come to say hi? I love you. So, great news. My neighbor just called me 7 minutes ago and let me know that her dog is home. She's limping. She definitely got hit by a car, and I'm so excited to go and visit her. I'm just so happy that my neighbor has her dog back, and she liked the muffins. So, very, very good news all around. I finished Gods of Jade and Shadow, 5 out of 5 stars. No one's surprised. I thought it was a beautiful dark fairy tale with good creepy vibes. I thought it was a mesmerizing love story also. I have a couple packages here that I'm going to unbox, and then I'm gonna start reading Even If We Break.
Yeah, I love you. Yeah, I love you.
Okay, can you leave so I can unbox? Thank you. This is part of the shipment that my bestie sent me. Oh shit okay. Honestly, I have the best friend in the world. Yes. Okay, so this is an arc of the historians. I do love my historical fiction. I always have, and I always will. You know what, I'm gonna save the synopsis for later because my dog is getting into trouble as usual.